It's time for another meeting of
the Science Alliance!
Hi, I'm Rex.
And I'm Judy. Today we're going to be talking about something that can be found in three different states.
Here, it's solid. What is it?
Water!
Right. Okay, Bryant, what's our first question?
Our first question comes from Joyce. She wants to know, why do we need water?
We use water for many different things. What do you use it for, Jeff?
A fire extinguisher.
How about you?
To drink.
Stephanie?
Swimming.
And Charlotte?
Electricity.
That's a good one.
Plants use water, too. In fact, fruits and vegetables are mostly water. Some members of the Science Alliance have done some tests to see how much water is contained in fruits or vegetables. They found the mass of the food and then sealed the fruit or vegetable in a plastic bag and left it for a couple of weeks. Donald tested a potato. Now, Donald, what was the mass of the potato a couple of weeks ago?
100 grams.
100. And now what is the mass of the potato?
80 grams.
80 grams. And this liquid appeared. If you were to test this liquid, you would see that it's water. Sarah, what did you test?
Grapes.
Grapes. And what was the mass of the grapes when you started?
40 grams.
40 grams. And now what is the mass?
20 grams.
20 grams. And again, this liquid appeared. The grapes had a mass of 40 grams. And now they have a mass of 20 grams. So how much was lost? Right, 20 grams, or about half of the mass. If you were to test other fruits and vegetables, you would see that they all contain water.
People contain water too. About 3/5 of the human body is water. You can see some of this water when you exercise. Your body loses it through perspiration. If you don't replace your body water, you can dehydrate, just like the fruits and vegetables did in our test. In cold weather, you can see water escaping from your body just by breathing. The cloud that escapes from your mouth is water vapor condensing in the cold air. Water vapor is water as a gas. Water as a gas, a liquid, or a solid can be found all over the earth. In fact, about 3/5 of the earth's surface is covered with water. We use water for transportation and recreation too. Water is important for life.
Our next question comes from Edmund, who asks, what is the water cycle?
A cycle is an activity that continually repeats itself. Plants absorb water from the soil and release it through their leaves. This water, and the water from rivers, lakes, and oceans, evaporates into the air and becomes water vapor. As the air cools, the water vapor condenses, becoming a liquid again. Some of this water falls to the earth as rain or snow. The rain is absorbed into the soil or flows into the rivers, lakes, and oceans, and the water cycle begins again.
We can show you a model of a water cycle using this terrarium. We have some moss, some ferns, even a little container to simulate a lake. The plants in the terrarium absorb water from the soil and release water into the air through their leaves. This water is condensing or becoming a liquid on the glass sides and top of the terrarium. The water falls to the soil, the plant absorbs it, and the cycle repeats itself. If you look around, you'll see water in various states as it goes through the water cycle.
Naomi asks, why is water called H2O?
Everything on Earth is made of atoms. Their names and symbols appear on this chart. For example, there's carbon, or C, nitrogen, or N, oxygen, or O. Now, some things are made of combinations of different atoms. Salt is made up of sodium, Na, and chlorine, Cl. So the chemical formula for salt is NaCl. Table sugar is made up of carbon, or C, hydrogen, or H, and oxygen, or O. Now, the smallest particle of sugar is called a molecule. The recipe for one molecule of sugar is 12 parts of carbon, 22 parts of hydrogen, and 11 parts of oxygen. So the formula for sugar is C12, H22, O11. Water is made up of hydrogen, or H, and oxygen, or O. Each molecule of water is made up of 2 parts of hydrogen to 1 part of oxygen. So water is H2O. So as you can see, many things are formed from atoms of the elements found
Thank
on
you.
This chart.
Thank you. That's my first word,
just
and that
second,
means...
Just a second, Bryant, just a second. I want to make sure that everyone understands what an element is. An element is the purest form of a substance, and the periodic table lists all the elements. Okay, Bryant, take it away.
All right. And now it's time for Bryant's Science of Science. Henry Cavendish was a wealthy chemist who lived over 200 years ago. He didn't like people, but he certainly liked science. In one of his experiments, he dropped pieces of iron into a strong acid. When the acid and iron started to bubble, Cavendish used a test tube to collect the gas that was given off. When he brought a flame near the test tube, the gas exploded. Cavendish decided, "I've discovered a new element. I'll call it inflammable air." Joseph Priestley was another scientist who lived at that time. He had discovered a gas that would cause a glowing piece of charcoal to burst into flame. He called his gas dephlogisticated air. He heard about Cavendish's discovery and wondered what would happen if the gas Cavendish had found were mixed with the gas he had discovered. He mixed the two gases and set off an electric spark. Pop! Just a loud noise, he thought. He noticed the inside of the container was a bit wet, but nothing else had happened. Cavendish tried the same experiment. Priestley was right, Cavendish thought. Nothing but a pop. But what is that liquid? Cavendish decided to test the liquid. It's water, he said. Water is made up of inflammable air and dephlogisticated air. Today, we know these two gases as hydrogen and oxygen. Bryant salutes Priestley and Cavendish, who discovered the elements of water, and truly two great giants of science.
Thank you, Bryant. We can separate water to show you that it does contain hydrogen and oxygen with this apparatus. This can be a dangerous experiment, so don't try it yourself. Both test tubes are filling up with gas, but one test tube is filling up more quickly than the other. If there's twice as much hydrogen than oxygen in water, then the test tube with the greater amount of gas should contain hydrogen, and the other test tube should contain oxygen. You test for oxygen with a glowing splint. This is oxygen. You test for hydrogen with a flame. This is hydrogen. So you can see that water is made up of two parts hydrogen and one part oxygen. Water is H2O.
Jennifer wants to know, how is water cleaned?
Different things can be found in water. You can find plants, fish, dirt, salt, and chemicals, to name a few. Sometimes we don't want these things in our water. There are many ways that water can be cleaned or purified. Here's one way. The red liquid in this beaker contains salt and food coloring. Would you taste it for me, Charlotte, to see what it tastes like?
Yes.
Well, how is it?
It tastes like salt.
Okay. Let's see what happens when I heat the water and cover the beaker with a pie plate. This will take a while, so we'll speed up the tape so we can view the whole process. Some of the salty red liquid has evaporated, leaving the salt and the food coloring behind. Clear water is forming on the pie plate. You want to try it, Charlotte, and see how it tastes?
Tastes normal.
This water has no salt or food coloring in it. It's pure. This way of cleaning water is called distillation.
There's another way to clean water. I have a container with some sand and gravel in it. I've made some holes in the bottom of the container. What will happen when I pour this muddy water into the container? The water that has passed through the sand and gravel isn't muddy. Most of the dirt has been trapped by the sand and gravel. We call this method of cleaning water filtration. We clean our drinking water from rivers and lakes by filtration too. We've shown you two ways water can be purified. distillation, and filtration.
Joe writes, can water do work?
We know from our show on machines that something does work if there is movement. Water as a gas does work in a machine like this. It's called a steam engine.
Thank you. And now it's time for Bryant's Science. James Watt was an inventor who lived over 200 years ago. He worked at the University of Glasgow in Scotland, fixing the university's scientific equipment. One day, a student showed Watt a new model in the science class.
I've never seen anything like it myself. It works on steam. When it works, it's usually broken.
I've never seen a steam engine, James Watt said, but perhaps I can fix it. Let's see how it works. They fired the boiler. After a little while, steam began to hiss from the side. This is no good, Watt said. Look, some of the steam is escaping from the sides of the boiler. I can make a better engine than this. Watt wrote to a wealthy man named Dr. John Roebuck, who owned a coal mine that was flooded with water. Dear Dr. Roebuck, Watt wrote, if you pay me, I will build you a special steam engine that will pump water out of your mine.
It's a deal, agreed Dr. Roebuck, and James Watt started to work.
He built a stronger boiler and a special movable valve to move the piston back and forth. When the day came for the final test, Dr. Roebuck and the student came to watch. Watt filled the boiler with water and heated the engine. Everyone listened to the steam build up inside the boiler. But in Watt's steam engine, no steam leaked out the sides.
It's moving, cried Dr. Roebuck. And sure enough, the piston began to move back and forth, and the wheel turned around faster and faster. This engine is marvelous, shouted Dr. Roebuck. It will pump all the water from my coal mine.
Bryant salutes James Watt, who improved the steam engine so that it could be used to do work, and truly a great giant of science.
Thank you, Bryant. James Watt showed us how steam can be used to do work. Here's another way that water can be used to do work. Watch what happens when I pour water over the wheel. So water is doing work. Water wheels like this have been used for centuries.
Water wheels can also be used to generate electricity. In a hydropower plant, water is used to turn the water wheels called turbines, and they turn the generators, which produce electricity. Hydroelectricity means electricity from water.
Here are some more things you might like to find out about water. Where did the dirt in this kettle come from?
Why is the ocean salty?
There are many ways to find out the answers to our questions.
And there are many more things you might like to find out about water.
Before we see you at our next meeting of the Science Alliance, find out all you can by experimenting, reading books, and talking to people. Have fun. Bye.
Bye-bye.